Call this meeting of the Township Board to order. Would everyone please rise for the Pledge of Allegiance?
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Mrs. West will be a few minutes later. Roll call, please.
Mr. Reynolds.
Here.
Mr. Gillham.
Here.
Mr. Pearl.
Here.
Mr. Cannon.
Here.
Mrs. West will be here shortly. Mr. Sowerby.
Here.
Mrs. Meltzer here.
Thank you. And are there any additions or deletions to tonight's agenda?
Yes, there are two deletions. Item number four, amended site development plan, conditional zoning agreement, Hillcrest Senior Housing Development at Hillcrest Moravian Hills. And item number 10, request approval to host concert at 43843 Romeo Plank.
So moved. Second.
Please.
Mr. Pearl.
Yes.
Mr. Reynolds.
Yes.
Mr. Gillham.
Yes.
Mr. Cannon.
Yes.
Mr. Sowerby.
Yes.
Mrs. Meltzer, yes. Motion passes.
Thank you. We have eight items on the agenda this evening. If you have anything to say about any of those items, please come to the podium and clearly give us your name and address for the record. If you have something you would like to discuss that is not part of tonight's agenda, please fill out a public comment card that is to your left in the front of the room. With that, we'll begin with item number one. Request permission to conduct the annual Clintondale High School Homecoming Parade.
Hi, I am requesting permission from the Township for Clintondale High School to have their annual parade on Friday, October 14th, 2016, from 4 p.m. to 5:30 p.m. The parade route is the same as last year, and attachment of the route is included. Alexander Taylor, Clintondale, mathematics instructor, class of 2017 advisor.
Move to approve.
If I could, I'd like to make that motion as a proud alumnus of Clintondale. Go Dragons.
Support. A roll call, please.
Mr. Gillham?
Yes.
Mr. Reynolds?
Yes.
Mr. Pearl?
Yes.
Mr. Cannon?
Yes.
Mr. Sowerby?
Yes.
Mrs. Meltzer, yes. Motion passes.
Thank you. And item number two, request permission to host a church revival with a tent on Colchester Street.
I'm requesting approval for the use of a temporary tent at 42448 Colchester Church of the Living God on July 22nd and 23rd of 2016. We're hosting a church revival. I would like to be placed on the July 11th, 2016 Board of Trustees agenda. Thank you for your attention to my request. Alice Vaughn.
Thank you. Are there any comments or questions?
Move to approve.
Thank you. Is there a second?
Support.
A roll call, please.
Mr. Pearl?
Yes.
Mr. Gillham?
Yes.
Mr. Reynolds?
Yes.
Mr. Cannon?
Yes.
Mr. Sowerby?
Yes.
Mrs. Meltzer, yes. Motion passes.
Thank you. And item three, request to be recognized as a nonprofit organization, Families Exploring Down Syndrome.
Dear Kim, I am writing this letter to request being added to the agenda of the July 11th, 2016 board meeting. I am a representative of a nonprofit organization called Families Exploring Down Syndrome. We support families that have a loved one with Down syndrome in Southeast Michigan. We will be holding a fundraising awareness walk on September 24th, 2016, in which we would like to hold a 50-50 raffle and silent auction. We would like to request a local governing body resolution for charitable gaming license. Our P.O. box is located in Sterling Heights, and our meetings are held in Clinton Township at the Macomb Intermediate School District, in which we meet once a month. I will send all required documents that you have requested prior to this board meeting per our conversation today, and thank you for your consideration. Katie Coe, Families Exploring Down Syndrome.
Thank you. Are there any comments or questions of board members?
The applicant has submitted verification from the IRS of their 501c3 status, and they've complied with all of our requests. And additionally, we are here to approve the local governing per the state's requirement, the local governing body resolution for charitable gaming licenses.
Thank you.
And they are here. I don't know if they would want to come up and speak about their event and. Yeah, advertise, free advertisement.
I have a brochure.
Your names and address for the record, please.
Yeah, I'm Margie Wheelock, 918 Hampstead Lane, Rochester Hills, Michigan, 48309.
And I'm Katie Coe, and I'm 6043 Harbor Court, Washington, Michigan, 48094.
Thank you.
We're holding a awareness fundraising walk in September. Here's our brochure if you want to look at it. And this is what this 50-50 raffle and
Chinese auction.
And a silent auction we're holding is for.
Very good.
So in order for us to get the license, we were told we had to come to our local municipality.
Yes.
So that's why we're here.
Okay, and I think all the paperwork is in order.
Yep,
so a motion would be in order.
So moved.
Support.
Okay.
Roll call, please.
Mr. Pearl?
Yes.
Mr. Gillaham?
Yes.
Mr. Reynolds?
Yes.
Mr. Cannon?
Yes.
Mr. Sowerby?
Yes.
Mrs. Meltzer, yes. Motion passes.
Thank you.
And if you want to give the flyer to the clerk, she'll make sure it gets distributed to.
And thank you for volunteering your time.
Also, I will. Okay, I've got this.
Okay, item four has been deleted. Item five, proposed rezoning from RML multiple family residential low density to RMH multiple family residential high density. 14 and a half acres at 15 and a half mile. South of 15, I'm sorry.
Mr. Cannon?
Mr. Sowerby?
I'm not sure our representative on the Housing Commission is on her way. Maybe we can table this until she comes back, and then as soon as she's here, I'll make a motion to table this item.
I'll support that. Roll call, please.
Mr. Sowerby?
Yes.
Mr. Cannon?
Yes.
Mr. Reynolds?
Yes.
Mr. Gillaham?
Yes.
Mr. Pearl?
Yes.
Mrs. Meltzer, yes. Motion passes.
Then we will come back. Item six, proposed rezoning from OS1 office service low rise to RMH multiple family residential high density.
This commission has made review and held public hearing on the proposal to rezone the above referenced land as located east of Hayes Road, north of 19 Mile Road from OS1 office service low rise to RMH multiple family residential high density for the stated purpose of development with senior apartments. We hereby make recommendation for approval of the rezoning as requested, and the action was by unanimous vote. A copy of the notice of the June 23, 2016 public hearing containing legal description and general location sketch of the land in question is attached for your information and file. This matter was petitioned by Mr. Zeph Barija, Glen Arbor Building, LLC, 5232 22 Mile Road, Shelby Township, Michigan, 48317, as represented by Ms. Stacy Surgette. That's FVPM LLC, 45138 Cass Avenue, Utica, Michigan, 48317. We submit this proposal for consideration. Sincerely, Denise Trombley, Secretary for the Clinton Township Planning Commission.
Thank you. Are there any comments or questions of board members, members of the community? Seeing none, the floor is open for a motion.
So moved.
Is there a second?
Second.
Roll call, please.
Mr. Sowerby?
Yes.
Mr. Reynolds?
Yes.
Mr. Gillaham?
Yes.
Mr. Pearl?
Yes.
Mr. Cannon?
Yes.
Mrs. Meltzer, yes. Motion passes.
Item 7, Smart Municipal and Community Credit Allocations for 2016-2017.
Dear board members, attached for your review and approval is the 2016-17 Municipal and Community Credit Smart Contract with SMART. The total dollar amount and program remains the same as last year and is as follows. For the municipal credits, the community buses of $95,190. Charter buses, zero. For the community credits, community buses are $100,405, and the charter buses, $26,500, for a total for municipal credits of $95,190 and a total community credit of $126,905. If you have any questions related to this matter, please call me. Sincerely, Donna Loretti, Finance Director.
Thank you. Are there any comments or questions? Members of the community? Bill?
Yes, thank you. This is the program that the SMART puts out to the communities to provide local community bus rides for persons with disabilities, senior citizens, and certain students to be able to ride and get to their destinations and doctor's appointments, shopping, things of that sort. We have three buses that are constantly on the road. And this year, earlier in the year, the board took action to now subsidize this program with some additional general fund dollars, and which was good to keep this program strong. It will have to be looked at again in the future, but what's important is this board has been very committed to this program through SMART, and we're excited to continue this and get these dollars again for the next fiscal year from SMART to keep this program going. So we hope that there's continued support from the board because the public very much appreciates it.
Thank you. Would you like to make the motion?
I'll make that motion to approve the SMART credits.
Support.
Thank you. Roll call, please.
Mr. Sowerby?
Yes.
Mr. Pearl?
Yes.
Mr. Reynolds?
Yes.
Mr. Gillaham?
Yes.
Mr. Cannon?
Yes.
Mrs. Meltzer, yes. Motion passes.
Thank you. Item 8 is appoint appraisal 2 position in the assessing department.
Dear Dear members of the board, the assessing department is recommending the appointment of Ms. Michelle Catalupo to the position of Appraiser 2. This appointment constitutes a promotion to a higher classification. Based on interviews, the assessing department is confident that Ms. Catalupo is well qualified for the position. This is a budgeted position. Ms. Catalupo's starting salary will be $54,054. Upon Township Board approval, her appointment date will be July 21st, 2016. Thank you for consideration of this matter. Sincerely, William Smith, Human Resources Director.
Thank you. Is there a motion to approve?
So moved.
Moved by Mr. Sowerby, supported by Mr. Reynolds. Roll call, please.
Mr. Sowerby?
Yes.
Mr. Reynolds?
Yes.
Mr. Gillingham?
Yes.
Mr. Pearl?
Yes.
Mr. Cannon?
Yes.
Mrs. Meltzer, yes. Motion passes.
Thank you. We will be coming back to your item in a minute.
I appreciate it.
Mr. Sowerby,
I heard that. Thank you.
Item 9 is discussion regarding cable director position.
Dear members of the board, I am writing to request that we formally appoint Jim Perpich to the position of cable TV communications director. As you all know, we lost Joe Peruzzi to a well-deserved retirement in January and Linda Badamo in February to a premature death. I personally miss both of them very much, and I know you do also. Mr. Perpich was hired as the assistant to the department head, but has been functioning as the director since his first day on the job in February. He has been doing the job as director and thus has been paid accordingly. I believe it is now time to formalize what has existed since Mr. Perpich started with us. He has done an outstanding job and is well-liked by his as well as the rest of the township staff. Sincerely, Robert Cannon, Supervisor.
Thank you. Are there any comments or questions?
Sure you want this position, Mr. Perpich?
I'd like to say I think he's doing a great job. He works really well with everybody in the township. He brings a lot of talent to the township, and we're really lucky to have him.
I agree.
So
thank you.
So I move to approve.
Support.
Thank you. Roll call, please.
Mrs. West?
Yes.
Mr. Pearl?
Yes.
Mr. Reynolds?
Yes.
Mr. Gillingham?
Yes.
Mr. Cannon?
Yes.
Mr. Sowerby?
Yes.
Mrs. Meltzer, yes. Motion passes.
Mr. Cannon?
Mr. Sowerby?
Make a motion to remove from the table item number 5.
Is there a second?
Second.
Roll call, please.
Mr. Sowerby?
Yes.
Mrs. West?
Yes.
Mr. Reynolds?
Yes.
Mr. Gillingham?
Yes.
Mr. Pearl?
Yes.
Mr. Cannon?
Yes.
Mrs. Meltzer, yes. Motion passes.
Thank you. And item number 5 is proposed rezoning from RML Multiple Family Residential to RMH Multiple Family Residential High Density at Village Road.
This commission has made review and held public hearing on the proposal to rezone the above referenced land as located south of 15 Mile Road between Gratiot and Harper Avenues from RML Multiple Family Residential Low Density to RMH Multiple Family Residential High Density for the stated purpose of redevelopment of the existing village housing with senior housing. We hereby make recommendation for approval of the rezoning as requested, and this action was by unanimous vote. A copy of the notice of the June 23, 2016 public hearing containing legal description and general location sketch of the land in question is attached for your information and file. This matter was petitioned by Ms. Ebony Nugent, Director of the Clinton Township Housing Commission, 34947 Village Road, Clinton Township, Michigan, 48035, as represented by Mr. Eric Gold, RAD Conversion Specialist, LLC, 32500 Telegraph Road, Suite 222, Bingham Farms, Michigan, 48025. We submit this proposal for consideration. Sincerely, Denise Trombley, Secretary for the Clinton Township Planning Commission.
Thank you. Mrs. West, you have the floor if you'd like to expound upon this.
I'd like Ebony and Eric to come forward. Thank you, Mr. Chairman. I'm sorry. This is to actually change from a low density to a high density. We're going to build the 70 units for the. Look, we have pictures or we have drawings. We're going to build the 70 unit senior portion in the back, and then the other portion will have the other 75 units on it. So it would make it high density from the current 100 units in total. I do know that there might be some sort of picture or something that he might have here, but all 145 would be right there on that property.
Currently, we have approximately 30 senior units all total, give or take. We will then now have 70
in a building.
That portion has been extremely successful in the development. So that's what you're asking for the expansion on. All said and done, all the units that are there currently would be torn down eventually.
Right.
With new units installed. So you would end up with 145 brand new units, 70 dedicated strictly to senior citizens.
Yes. And if you look at the picture that's down on the floor, that's actually what the senior units would look like. It'll be three floors. It'll have a gathering room down on the first floor. It'll have some rooms for services down on the first floor. And then it'll also have some parking, et cetera, for the seniors that do drive. It will be gated so that they will have, you know, they will have a gate around there. And then the other units are on the other portion. And you guys are much more eloquent at this, I hope.
Well, the bottom line is we're not approving any site plans right now. We're not approving any elevations.
But
what we're approving is a rezoning.
Correct.
So if you are in agreement with the concept, then it would be appropriate to make a motion to rezone the property. And it includes no other properties. It includes only the existing property.
Yeah.
If I could, I remember a few months back, we did have a presentation from the individuals from HUD that came here to really talk about sort of the changes at HUD and how their focus is now realizing that it's not a good idea to concentrate poverty in one section. And this is sort of the beginning phases of this, is it not?
Well, yes. And we did, when you talk about the presentation, you're talking about when they came here.
Yeah,
right.
Exactly.
We still are looking at some other properties. I don't really want to comment on them because we haven't zeroed in on anything. We do know the properties that we talked about at the last one were over off of Quinn Road, and those are all in a swamp. So we can't, that's swamp land basically, so we can't even build on it if we wanted to.
Okay.
I know that Eric and his counterpart, Bob Beal, have looked at some things, but we're not at this juncture ready to come forward. What we would like to do is, if we could, is if we get that property, we can kind of condense the numbers that are at this Village Road property in the way of the 75. We could bring that down, give them a little bit more breathing room, so to speak, mm-hmm. and then build some of the others. Some of the other properties that they've the RAD specialists have done actually have some lovely, like, duplex-type properties, which could be built on something else that we might find in the area. But we're not at that point. We kind of heard a lot of, at the last meeting, discord, I guess maybe I'll put it that way, that at least for the Quinn Road, that, you know, we for sure want to get this zoned correctly so that if we need to put everything on one property, we can do it. Does that make sense?
But the two things you're talking about is not tie barred.
Okay. Right. These are not.
Stands alone.
Right. This stands alone today.
Okay.
All right. Do I need to be? Did I do all of that correct?
Okay. No, and I,
okay.
Like Mr. Gillham said, I am returning from a convention with SEMCOG and their national group, and there was a lot of discussion on HUD's change of philosophy.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
I'll make a motion to approve the rezoning request.
Support.
Okay, we have discussion in the audience.
Anything?
Can we get your name and address for the record? If you just step aside for a second.
Have you seen the property downtown? Have you gone to see it?
No.
Okay, we need
Roger Holtsender, 23140 Wellington Crescent. As somebody, I deliver pizza in this area for 20 years. I tried to deliver into this area, and it simply became too dangerous for both this and for the Lipke Street next to it. Now, I hear there's going to be a gate to the senior thing. Is there going to be any staff on hand? I know other developments in Mount Clemens have a guard check where somebody's there and they, if they know who you are, they let you through, but if they don't know who you are, they stop you and ask what you're doing in the area if we're going to be increasing the amount of seniors in here, I don't want to put more seniors into a situation that's not beneficial to them.
No, but that's a good question. And Eric and Ebony, could you come forward? With regards to having any sort of guard or anything like that, I know that we've discussed that. I don't think we've zeroed in on it because we're still trying to decrease the kind of like spread out, I suppose that's the best word to say, and not have so many of the units, even though we have to, so, but that's still in discussion, as I understand it, correct?
There wouldn't necessarily be a guard. The building is going to be secure with entry cards or some similar device, and the parking will require either a key code or a card to get into the parking lot. But we don't at this point have plans to actually hire a security guard to sit in.
But that's for the senior part. I believe, yes. Correct me if I'm wrong, Roger, I think he's asking for the whole entire development. When, I mean, the development, I'm not sure, I don't think that you all did it, but over off of Joy Boulevard has a guard that's out there, and again, they don't let you in if they're, do we have plans for that? I thought we discussed it at one time.
It's still a possibility.
Okay.
But because we're zeroing, I'm sorry, because right now we were focusing on seniors, we haven't moved to the family site. That's something
right.
we can most definitely keep in mind,
right.
If budget allows, because that's a full-time position, part-time, right. so that's more expenses.
Okay.
But that's something we would look continue to look into.
So I have one more question.
No.
So the seniors are going to have a parking area that is fenced off from the rest of the
that's dedicated to them, correct.
And are they going to be able to get to their front door without, you know, what, still being in that protected area?
Right. Yes. They will get to their front door still in that protected area. Correct.
I think that's an improvement. Thank you.
And
thank
what
you.
What I would again say is that's speculation because that could change tomorrow. All we're doing is rezoning the property
right,
today.
Right, that's all we're doing today. But
that,
once
that is your idea going forward.
Right, right.
Thank you.
And oh, he definitely should be there.
Russell Holtzlander, 231401 Wellington Crescent. You're changing the you're rezoning because you're going to have a different building there. You're saying that it's neither not tie barred, that you could change the zoning and leave it the way it is?
We could change zoning and put more units on the property, and that's the purpose, from low density to high density. And what you're doing is you're, even though I believe the seniors are segregated at this time, they used to be anyway when I was on the housing board, it further puts the seniors living with seniors.
But what I'm saying is if you redo this rezoning, what's the odds if you decide this isn't right?
I'm sorry, I can't hear you.
If you decide that this isn't right, that you leave it the way it is now. I'm saying once you rezone it, it's going to happen.
Mr. Silvernagle, how many, that's correct. How many units total can they put on the site? Let's just say that the concepts that are being talked about tonight are thrown out for whatever reason. They're too costly, whatever. They're too big or too small. How many units total could be put on the site with the current rezoning request? Now, that is his question.
More than 7 units per acre, but it depends on rooms per acre. And until that happens, I can't give you a total number of units per acre. But like low density that we have right now, the maximum would be 7 units at. One bedroom per acre.
Okay.
So if there's 14 acres, the maximum under the old, the low density would be 98 approximately.
That's probably what they have
so
now.
They have 100 now, so the yes. So it would be more than
reverse,
that.
Well, for sure. But
it could be, for sure it's 145, it could be more. If they build up and they have available land, they have to have square footage per acre.
They couldn't put 300 units there.
No, not without going
there
up.
Is a limit.
Well, I'm just saying, because I'm saying that if you change the zoning, you're going to build different buildings, you're going to change it. You're not going to rezone it and then leave it the way it is.
Well, that has happened.
Well, but what I'm saying is you're insinuating that they're not, it's one thing is going to lead to the other.
Well, one thing leads to another, assuming
not exactly,
it's funded properly. That's
yeah, but
the key to this whole thing.
It's kind of being a little disingenuous there. It's not going to get changed. You're voting to change this, and then it's going to happen. Something is going to happen.
Potentially something's going to happen. That's
yes.
correct.
You talk to the community down there, of course?
A lot of talk has gone in with the community.
Okay, and what about the people that live there currently? Are they going to be moving into these places?
You know what, Ebony? Can you address that, please? Because I'm sure there's going to be some anxiety. there always is, and I'm assuming that the seniors who are currently there would be given first opportunity to move into the new units?
Yes. Right now, and we've gone back and forth because the plans have changed a few times. We had the Quinn Road that came off. So one of the things that we're looking at right now is having to relocate a certain number of residents that's right off of Village Road. They will go to private housing, their rent will remain subsidized, and then once the building is complete, they have first rights to the units.
They'd be basically given a voucher to go to another living accommodation.
Right, because their rent has to remain the same.
Gotcha.
And then they're moved to and from, we have to pay all moving expenses, but they have first right to come back.
So if they're paying like $60, $80 a month right now, when they move to the new place, it's still be
right. Their rent has to remain the same. So if their rent currently is $60 and the rent where they're going is $500, that $440 difference, we have to cover.
And then when they come back to this building,
they will still be at their $60.
Yeah, they would be subsidized the same.
Right, right. They will not lose subsidy.
So basically, it's first refusal rights.
We all know that the areas need to be improved, so good with that.
Plus, if I can throw one other thing in here, I'm sorry. One thing I know I'm going to be working with Ebony and also then Clintondale Schools is that there's 75 kids that are in the school district that we really want to make sure that those kids stay in the school district. So maybe others might be moved farther away, but the ones who have kids, we want to keep them in the school district. So that's a big important thing to us. So
thank you. We do have a motion on the floor and a support. Mr. Pearl?
Yeah, just a reminder that I've discussed this before, but when the developers come here with the site plan, I'd like to see the whole financing and the tax credit, how you're working that out, so that we make sure that it's feasible. And I think we'll get that opportunity at site plan. Mm-hmm. I'm in favor of the rezoning. I think we've talked about this for years, and I think it's a great idea.
It's a good first step, and it gives them the opportunity then to come back to us with further plans. So thank you.
Thank you.
And thank you to the Housing Commission that dedicates a lot of time as basically community volunteers. Roll call, please.
And I must say, I'm sorry. Thank you to actually the team of Eric and Bob and especially Ebony. She has been a godsend to that group over there. So
very good.
Thank you.
I've heard the same thing. A lot of good things about you.
Well, look at her. She's...
Guy by the name of Tom thinks really highly of you too.
Okay.
Roll call.
Mr. Sowerby?
Yes.
Mr. Reynolds?
Yes.
Mr. Gillingham?
Yes.
Mr. Pearl?
Yes.
Mr. Cannon?
Yes.
Mrs. West?
Yes.
Mrs. Moser? Yes. Motion passed.
Thank you. You're approved.
Thank you all.
Item 10 has been deleted. Approval of the minutes of the June 27th, 2016 regular township board meeting.
I have one amendment. Item 12. At the bottom of the paragraph, it says the last sentence, and Mr. Reynolds indicated he talked with Mr. Cannon, who's recommending this appointment. I was told by Mr. Santia that you recommended this appointment. I did not talk to Mr. Cannon directly.
Okay. What was the appointment?
Page 12.
It was for the economic.
Yes. Okay, that's fine.
Economic Development Corporation.
Okay, with that change.
So moved as amended.
Support.
Roll call, please.
Mr. Sowerby?
Yes.
Mrs. West?
Yes.
Mr. Reynolds?
Yes.
Mr. Gillingham?
Yes.
Mr. Pearl?
Yes.
Mr. Cannon?
Yes.
Mrs. Meltzer? Yes. Motion passes.
Approval of the bills?
So moved.
Support.
Thank you. Roll call, please.
Mr. Reynolds?
Yes.
Mrs. West?
Yes.
Mr. Gillingham?
Yes.
Mr. Pearl?
Yes.
Mr. Cannon?
Yes.
Mr. Sowerby?
Yes.
Mrs. Meltzer? Yes. Motion passes.
There are no public comments this evening, so a motion to adjourn is in order.
So moved.
Is there a second?
Second.
Roll call, please.
Mr. Reynolds?
Yes.
Mrs. West?
Yes.
Mr. Gillingham?
Yes.
Mr. Pearl?
Yes.
Mr. Cannon?
Yes.
Mr. Sowerby?
Yes.
Mrs. Meltzer? Yes. Motion passed.
Thank you. Meeting adjourned.